Earlier, we discussed Axon, second best performer in the S&P this month to only Palantir. Both companies focused on AI, security, defense tech. Similar story for C3 AI, Big Bear AI, also commercial space stocks, including Rocket Lab, which is up 140% plus this month, Planet Labs, Redwire, and space ETFs like Procure's UFO and ARK's ARKX ETF. Those are all soaring post-election. Why? Well, companies taking a commercial approach to working with the government and adopting new business models that shift risk from the taxpayer back to corporate balance sheets. Now, that enables the government to be one of many customers, what's called dual-use technology in some cases. These are the kinds of businesses expected to do well under an incoming Trump administration, especially in light of DOGE, with so many investors and entrepreneurs tied to defense tech and space involved with the administration. Now take Anduril Industries, which Vice President-elect Vance actually invested in. The $14 billion upstart is best known for attack drones, robot submarines, unmanned fighter jets, but it's also been forging further into another domain, space.
Now we're seeing all of these small businesses, medium-sized businesses who are working in the commercial space sector who don't really have the ability to transact with the U.S. government and may not even understand the full set of mission needs that the U.S. government has. And so we can operate as someone who can bring together and convene this set of companies. We're calling it the team of super friends who could come in and bring together an offering that is complete for the U.S. Space Force.
Now, super friends that already include other venture-backed darlings like Apex and Impulse Space, which was founded by SpaceX employee number one. Last week, Anduril won a $100 million program of record contract to upgrade the Space Force's space surveillance network. Anduril's senior vice president of engineering, Gokul Subramanian, says the company already has a payload on orbit, it's developing its own spacecraft, and is launching what is essentially edge computing at the edge of Earth.
Most spacecraft have less computation ability than your iPhone. They don't have the ability to run AI. They don't have the ability to run all sorts of processing. So we're taking modern day GPUs, right, the foundational hardware that's necessary to run AI processing, and we're getting that ready for the space environment. We're hardening it for the space environment.
And speaking of DOGE, Musk and Ramaswamy to meet with Republican congressional leadership next week. So keep an eye on that and keep an eye on this sector. But for more on my discussion with Anduril's Submarinian about space and about defense tech, check out Manifest Space. That's available wherever you get your podcasts. You can scan that QR code right there on your screen for the full conversation.